Well, what do we have here? Two small little oil lamps. See, back in the olden days, back before batteries were popular and flashlights were popular, you know, if you wanted to carry a little mini light with you, like, you know, kind of like what we'd carry now, like a mag light, you'd have to carry one of these. This is the equivalent of a pocket flashlight. Just carry this in your pocket. You know, fill it full of oil, give it a little light, adjust the wick, you know, for your intensity there. And then turn it all the way down when you're done. Yep, found these at a thrift store. This is the 1800's version of a mini mag light. Look at that. It's not very big at all. Look at that. Very nifty, huh? But man, it's getting dark. Hold on, let me pull out my mini mag light. There you go. That was it. I'm gonna have two of these. About the same size, as a matter of fact. Let me see. I don't know if you can see that or not. 98 cents. That one was also 98 cents. Bought them both. So there you go. My little thrift store adventure, I found two 1800 period mini mag lights. Yep. Okay, they're not really from the 1800s. They're just these little EBD miniature hurricane lights. I like them because they're actually real. And I'm going to go through and put some fuel in them and see what happens. So I'll be back.
Okay, well, I'm back.
What I decided to do is disassemble the lamps and put them on this steel cookie sheet. Actually, I think it's aluminum. Downstairs on the sink. Actually, on the stove by the sink. Lots of water. There's a little element. There is one. I have some fuel in here. Some Coleman kerosene quart fuel for use with Coleman kerosene appliances. All right, there's a little glass globe. So what I plan on doing is hopefully lighting these things up without setting the house on fire. So I'm gonna light some shit up in here. So I'll be back in a second, since I don't really have anybody to help me film. So I'll be back. Okay, screw the lid on this one. Use the wick in the bottom. Roll it in. Roll it out. Make sure. I can't tell if it's leaking or what, so let me see if it's... looks pretty straight. Eventually, this stuff will actually wick up to the top, and that's what you light. I'm not sure how long it takes. All right, so that one. Nice little cotton wick. There's this one. Both have fuel in them. Okay, screw this one on here. Yep. I was telling everybody that these are the equivalent of mag lights from like the 1800s. Like, well, you just whip this out of your pocket and light it up so you can see where you're going. You know, like we have like little mini flashlights. Yep. This thing doesn't want to screw on very well. Yeah. Had a lot of shoddy quality workmanship back in the olden days. Yeah. I think this one actually has a slight crack in it. So you have to be careful. So look at that. Good thing I'm next to the sink. That way when I catch on fire, if I do catch on fire, you keep filming, okay? dump that one up a little bit. Got the wick wet. Nice. I think this one's going to be the same. Just a quick dip. Wick is wet. Nice. Now, I'll separate them. Yeah, that one's kind of leaky. So, all right. You ready to do this?
Okay.
That was rhetorical. If fire breaks out, get ready to haul ass, okay? Fire. Fire and hole. Here we go. Ooh. Yeah. Turn it down a little bit. See how that one smoked up? Let's get this one. Ready? Find a hole.
No.
Ooh, smoky, smoky. You turn the wick down a little bit. Smoke stops. Too much wick, smoke. You see the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with a nice little glove. Too much, smokes. So the trick is you want to turn them down to where you have no black smoke. And then the other trick is to put a little glow bomb up, burning your face off. Just drop it down, put it on there, make sure I got it straight. There we go, there's that one. This one, same thing. All right, find the right sort of, make sure they're all on here. Yeah. Do a little bit of adjustment. Oh, a little too much, let me turn that down a little bit. See, I'll bend them just slightly. Oops, top's coming off. This one's probably gonna have to go in the trash when we get done. Yes, I know, if this thing breaks, I'll throw fuel all over the place and possibly burn myself to death, I understand. I'm exercising caution. There we go. Can't see. Yeah. There. There we go. See? Smoke? No. Same thing with this one. Smoke? No. So that's about as bright as it'll get. Not right there. So, let me go ahead and turn the light off. There you go, 1800 series mini lamps, aka mini mag light, mini flashlight slash nightlight. 98 cents a piece from the dollar store, or actually from the thrift store. Check it out. Look how bright they are. Let's see. What do you think? You like that?
They're neat.
Yeah. That's pretty cool. Do you know how to turn them off?
Pull the wick all the way down?
Yeah, I think so.
Blow on them?
Let's just turn it down first and see what happens. You ready?
Mm-hmm. Do it on the other one.
Do it on this one?
Yeah.
Oh. Ah, okay. Ready?
Mm-hmm. Slowly.
Out. Then you put the wick back up just a little bit. There you go. So you turn it down until the wick goes all the way inside. It snuffs it. And you bring it back up just a skosh to leave a little bit of white to light on next time. Yeah, look at that guy. He's so scary. Wait, let me get my flashlight. Man, living in the 1800s is probably a pain in the ass. Can you imagine carrying that thing around in your pocket the whole time? Very nice.
Your flashlight?
Omi says she's seen something in the tree, so I'm going to take my candle, my 1800 mag light, and go find out what it is. Okay. Let me know where it is. Scary. I could just use a regular flashlight, but this is... Oh, I don't see anything. Could be scary. Homie's looking for it too. You see anything?
No, it went to that crook in the tree and stopped.
Okay. We use the amazing power of the 1800 era mag light.
And what? I'm not going over there.
Go over there.
No.
You can go over there. I'm filming, woman. Go ahead. I'll go with you.
Can I have a rock or a stick?
You don't need a rock or a stick. You
yes,
have that
I
light.
Do.
You have that little light right there.
It could be a monster.
What is it?
is, it probably has rabies.
Well, if it doesn't, it's good eating.
Stop. Oh my god, I saw it jump.
What is it?
It's all the way up there.
Oh yeah, my camera won't do that.
Yeah, because it's in the dark.
You think it's a squirrel or a possum or a raccoon or a
maybe
rat or something?
A very small possum or a decent-sized Norway rat. Oh my god. No, I'm not. I can't even see it now.
Okay. Well, we're not going to eat that.
No, I'm not.
Okay, let's go ahead and turn the lamp off. We don't want to see where our claw our eyes out. There you go. Very cool little lamp. One candle power. Yeah.